Vermin, not exactly what I expected.
Well, maybe you shouldn't judge people before you get to know them.
Ouch.
So, tell me about my groom-to-be, Lord Farquaad. What's he like?
Well, let's just put it this way, Princess. Men of Farquaad's stature are in short supply.
Really?
Yeah, but he's a little intimidating.
Well, he must be.
And you're very good at small talk.
What are you doing?
I'm just saying I want to lower expectations a little bit.
Yeah, like 3 feet or so.
All right, yuck it up. Doesn't bother me, not today. After a lifetime of misery, things are finally going my way.
A lifetime of misery? Yeah, okay.
You chuckled.
Hmm?
When I said lifetime of misery, you chuckled.
Did I?
You did.
Look, I'm sure it was very hard living in a dragon guard tower.
It was.
I'm sure.
All right, then.
Although, it must have been nice to have a cozy bed, a roof over your head, more than I had when I left home.
You're not actually comparing yourself to what I endured.
I'm just saying, you don't corner the market an unhappy childhood.
There are things you don't know, you know, about me, about how rough I've had it.
What, you want to show him pool a couple of times?
I mean about my life.
In that cushy tower?
Cushy? Are you kidding? I had nothing in that tower, fighting boredom by the hour. Princess lonely, walking in circles. I had only bare essentials, army cut, a hot plate, and a chamber pot. And every morning I would boil it. No choice, I had no toilet, just a view of devastation. Out one window, isolation in my bedroom, and very little head. For 20 years I sat and waited. I'm very dedicated. On the walls the names were added. Luckily those walls were padded. So I think I got you beat. I think I got you.
Sad story, but I've been better. I'm just saying, pay for effort. Thanks for playing. Sad to see a princess suffer, but I had it rough. Like that time a mob with torches burned my britches. See the scorches? You're just whining. I had a flaming hiney. As I fled, I had to wonder if I were torn asunder, would an ogre go to heaven? Did I mention I was seven? No. So, I think I got you beat. I think I got you beat. Yeah, 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 yeah. I think I got you beat. I think I got you.
Nerd Day.
birthday.
I was sent away on Christmas Eve.
Duh.
Ha ha. The essentials no are he got a holy energy for potted. Every no morning I was toilet. No choice, I had no toilet. The building would devastate. Now was window isolation in my bedroom and very little headroom. 20 years I sat and waited.
You will. Oh, no, too smutty. But soft. What's light through yonder window breaks? It is Fiona, and Farquhar is the sun!
My lord, we just received word Princess Fiona has been rescued. She's on her way now.
On her way? Rah! She's on her way, and so am I! My fairy tale princess! I always said I'd be king, and now look, the last adorable piece to my master plan! Ooh, that reminds me, how are the wedding preparations coming?
All in order, my lord. We've booked the cathedral and the band.
Although, I was wondering if maybe you'd like to invite your father?
My what?
Your father, my lord.
Do you mean that horrible little man who tried to keep me down my whole life? That mal-tempered monster? That vile grunt who abandoned me in the woods when I was just a child?
Well, he did have his reasons.
Like he pleased. My father simply couldn't accept that I wanted nothing to do with the family business. That lowly, dirty family business. My daddy was a miner who wasn't much around. Foraging for diamonds, a life spent underground. Daddy didn't talk much, he barely said hello. He simply muttered, hi-ho. Head off to work he'd go. She rolled over, and Mama was gone. Daddy was broke. Me and my old man, a tale as old as dirt. A bitter, distant father in a tiny undershirt. Daddy up and left me good as dead. Now he lives in squalor, sleeping seven to a bed.
Oh, you abandoned me in the woods, Daddy.
But I crawled out and up. Oh, if you could only see me now, Daddy. I'd invite you to the wedding, but you have to be this tall to get in! My bride-to-be is gorgeous, her wedding dress designer. The guest list will be major, without a minor, minor. Packs of royal lackeys, playing violin.
Strings of royal underlings.
Who will know that you win? Aha! Aha!
Snuthers, I was gonna make us.
Snuthers?
They're traditional Ogre campfire snacks. They're like s'mores, but instead of marshmallows and chocolate, we use squirrel gizzards and mulch. Flavor's just melt in your mouth.
I think I need to sit down for a second.
No sitting, Donk. We have to get the princess to do love.
No! Trap. Look, I may not get another chance to try one of those snuggers.
Well, I'm sorry. If you try one, you're probably not going to be able to try anything.
Zip it, donkey.
I was just thinking, maybe you love to wait until morning.
Morning?
Yeah, I mean, I spent my whole life without true love. What's one more night?
All right, then. I'll get us some dinner.
I'll get the fire. Oh,
sorry.
I'm just gonna.
Okay, go together?
Sure.
Okay, you guys can see what I'm seeing.
There is something going on around here. See, I've been watching and the signals are clear. A nervous laugh when she brushes his skin. The sweaty palms, the big dopey grin. With a giggle and a flip of a hair, I smell the pheromones in the air. Making cuckoo eyes over their food. They need my help here in setting the mood. Oh! Don't believe love is blind? Well, I got some friends who think otherwise. And here they are. Watch this up, girls.
See how we
run. You gotta turn up the heat. You gotta butter the pit. You gotta
make a move and don't be afraid.
Reach your hand, maybe give her a kiss.
She's waiting for a
fireflies
That big, bright, beautiful sunset.
Sunset? Oh my gosh, but it is late. It is very late.
What?
I know what the problem is. You're afraid of the dark.
Yes, I am. Terrified. You know, I better go inside.
See, I know how to fix this. See, once I was afraid of the dark. I'm still afraid of the dark.
I'd better go inside. Sorry. Good night.
Good night.
Come here. We're not doing this. I am sorry, but I did not put up with you and your body odor just for you to let her walk away like that.
What are you talking about?
I am an animal and I have instincts. You guys are obviously digging up on each other.
What are you talking about? I'm just here to take her to Far Park.
So you mean to tell me you have no feelings for her at all?
Look, even if I did, and I'm not saying I do because I don't, she's a princess and I'm...
an ogre.
Yeah, an ogre.
Well, she needs to know.
Where are you going?
To get more wood before your flyer dies! Princess Fiona! Princess? Look, it is very spooky out here, and I told you I'm afraid of the dark. I am playing no games right now. Oh, this is low. Ah, oh, my God. Ooh, Princess, where are you, Princess? Princess! Oh,
no!
God!
No! 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 Stop it! Stop it!
What have you done with the princess?
Donkey, it's me. I am the princess in this body.
Oh my God, you ain't the princess? Keep breathing, I will get you out of there.
Donkey!
Princess, what happened to you?
By day one way, by night another, this shall be the norm. Until you find true love's first kiss, and then take love's true
Oh my God, that was beautiful, Princess. I didn't know you wrote poetry.
It's a curse. I've had it since I was a girl.
A curse?
A witch casts a spell on me, so now, every night after sunset, I turn into this hideous, ugly beast.
Okay, calm down. You are not that ugly. Okay, never mind. You are ugly, but see, you only look like this at night. Shrek, he's ugly 24/7. Oh my God, this is perfect.
Perfect? Donkey, if Lord Farquaad finds out I look like this, he'll never marry me.
So?
So I need to kiss my true love. That's the only way curse will be broken.
But you're kind of an ogre. And Shrek, I think you guys have a lot in common.
Shrek?
Yeah, I feel like if he knew all of this, then it wouldn't be-
No! No, Donkey, he can't know, and you can't tell him. Promise you won't tell. Promise.
All right, fine. I double dealt to new sister swear.
Parkour?
Man, I know after this, I am going to need a lot of serious therapy.
Right, so, Princess, how are you? Good? I'm good. I'm okay. I picked this flower right over there. Is where it grew, and I don't really like it, but it made me think of you because it's pretty. It's what I'm trying to say, and you are also pretty, but I like you anyway. So please accept this flower with its petals and the stem, which represent my feelings, and tell you how... Man, I'm in trouble. When words fail, what will I do? When words fail, how will she know how I feel? Words fail. moon is out tonight. You remind me of that moon because it's big and bright. And by big, I don't mean chubby. Obviously, you're not fat, but your personality is biggish, is what I meant by that. Sorry about that fat thing, I'm on the healthy side myself. Have to blame the gene pool, which reminds me of... Wait, where am I going with this? When words fail, what will I do? When words fail, how will she know how I feel? When words fail, will I fail too? Do I have a snowball chance? Are my prospects just too grim? I spent my life stuck in the mud, and now I'm crawling out on a limb. If words fail, she'll know what I mean. If words fail, she'll just take my hand. She sees me like no one else has. If words fail, she'll understand. She'll understand. Woo!
Not now. I mean, I'm a princess after all, and look at me. I mean, really, who could love a beast so hideous and ugly? Princess and ugly don't go together. That's why I can't stay here with Shrek. My only chance to live happily ever after is to marry my one true love. I've had a long and sleepless night pondering true love. My fairy tale I know so well has somehow gone awry. Looks can be deceiving, but feelings cannot lie. Last night I was uncertain, but this morning, Shrek, thank goodness you're here. There's something I have to tell you.
You don't have to tell me anything. I heard enough last night.
Oh, you heard what I said?
Every word, especially the hookah is a hideous, ugly beast.
But I thought that wouldn't matter to you.
Yeah, well, it does. Oh, right on time. Princess, I brought you a little something.
Fiona. Well there, Bordeaux. Princess Fiona
has promised about my swamp.
Cleared off is agreed, and the deed has been put in your name. Now step away before I change my mind. Forgive me, Princess, for startling you. I am Lord Farquaad.
Forgive me, Lord Farquaad, for I was just saying a short farewell.
Oh, that is so sweet, but you don't have to waste good manners on the ogre. It's not like it has feelings.
No, you're right. It doesn't.
Princess Fiona, beautiful, fair, flawless Fiona. I ask your hand in marriage. Will you be the perfect bride to the perfect groom?
Lord Farquaad, I accept. Nothing would make
me... Excellent! I'll start the plans for tomorrow! We win!
No! I mean... Why, wait! Let's get married today. Before sunset.
Ooh, anxious, are we? Captain, ride ahead and tell them it's a code of red! You're right. There's so much to do. We'll be married by sunset!
Man, there is nothing like a good night's sleep.
Fare thee well, ogre.
Shrek, what are you doing? You're letting her get away. Look, there is something you do not know. I spoke to her last
night. Yeah, I know you talked to her last night. You two are such great pals, aren't you? Why don't you follow her home?
But I want to come home with you.
Hey, I told you already, I live alone. My swamp, me. Nobody else. Understand? Especially not useless, annoying, pathetic talking donkeys.
But I thought...
Yeah? Well, you know what? You thought wrong. I'm gonna build me a wall.
Ow!
I'm talking 10 feet high. See you later, pal. Bye-bye. Ain't no one getting in, so don't you even try. A 10-foot wall. I'm gonna dig me a moat. I'm talking 10 feet deep. And then maybe I'll get some sleep. Piranha keeping guard. So look before you leap into my moat. Give an inch and they drag me a mile. When I'm out in the world, I'm under attack with the face that lost a thousand insults. Well, bon voyage! Cause I'm never coming back. I'm gonna lay myself down. I'm not going nowhere. One room and one easy chair. That's all I ever wanted and all I can bear. Gonna lay myself down. What a fool to think she might love. I opened my heart and let her walk through. She wanted Prince Charming, I wanted my home back. How lucky both our wishes came true. I'm gonna build a wall for a place to hide. Hey world, stay on your side. The best way to they say it's to divide. I'm gonna build a wall, I'm gonna dig me a moat, gonna lay myself down. I'm gonna build a
Gingy's right. Meet the girl for a fluffy butt and do something.
Now, wait a minute. Maybe that ogre wasn't the answer, but something better will come along, and we just have to wait for it. Because that's what fairy tale creatures do. We wait for miracles. We wish upon stars. Why, my cricket always fooled me.
Forget the cricket! If you were so smart, you would have seen that windshield coming.
No, no, we just need to lay low until this all blows over.
Lay low!
No, none of this would have happened if I was just a real boy. Why can't I be a real boy?
Listen up, puppet! We spend our whole lives wishing. We weren't so freaking strange. But I'll feel that way.
Okay, Gigi!
We'll need to check the age.
The way they think, that is.
That's right, Papa!
Oh,
talking about what he thinks he saw. Go on, sing it. Gonna build a wall while I show his ass a wall. I'm sorry, say that again.
What are you doing?
Oh, I thought you, of all people, would know a wall when you saw one.
Yeah, well, the wall is supposed to go around my swamp, not through it.
See, it is around your half. That's your half, this is my half.
Oh, your half.
Yes, my half. I helped rescue the princess, I did half the work, I get half the booty.
Oh, back off.
You back off.
Stubborn jackass.
Smelly ogre.
This is my swamp.
There you go again, all my, and me. Well, now it's my turn, so just shut up and pay attention. You are mean to me. You insult me and you never appreciate anything I do. You're always pushing me around or pushing me away. You're so wrapped up in layers, onion boy. You're afraid of your own feelings.
Yeah, well, if I hurt you so bad, then why'd you come back?
Because that's what friends do. They forgive each other.
Oh, hey.
There you go again, just like you did to Fiona. All she ever did was like you, maybe even love you.
Love me? She said I was a hideous creature.
She wasn't talking about you, she was talking about someone else.
She wasn't talking about me? Then what's she talking about?
No, you wanna listen to me, right?
Donkey. I'm sorry. I'm sorry. Donkey, look, I apologize. I guess I am just a big, stupid, ugly ogre. Can you forgive me?
Well, I guess that's what friends are for, right?
Yup. Friends?
Yeah, friends!
What did Princess say about me?
Why are you asking me? Why don't you go ask her yourself?
Ask her myself?
You want to be a hero, now's your chance.
Donkey, the wedding, we're not gonna make it in time.
Now, what kind of noble steed would I be if I didn't have a plan? Follow me!
But showing up when invited to a wedding.
Now you want to talk? Well, it's a little late for that, so if you'll excuse me?
You can't marry him.
And why not?
Because he's marrying you just so he can become king.
That is outrageous! Fiona, don't listen to him.
He isn't your true love.
What do you know about true love?
Oh, this is precious. The ogre has fallen in love with the princess. Oh, good lord. Guards, take this abomination out of my
sight. No! I mean, let's listen to what the monster has to say.
Ooh, you are awful. Go on, ogre. You heard her. Express yourself with as few groans as possible.
Right. Okay, it's a big bright
happiness all around. It's peaches and cream. If a dream comes true,
awkward.
It's a big, bright, beautiful world with possibilities everywhere. If true love is blind, maybe you won't mind the view. I know I'm not the handsome prince for whom you waited. I don't have a fancy castle, and I'm not sophisticated. A princess and an ogre, I'll admit, it's complicated. You never read a book like this, but every tale should really be updated. It now, I'll let it in. I'll tear down a wall and save a spot for two. To be with you.
Are we ready, darling?
I can't.
By night, this shall be the moment.
Once upon a time to look like us would be a pity, but now we know that beautiful ain't always pretty.
Love me as I look, standing here in all my glory. I am sweetness, I am bratty, I'm a princess, I'm a baddie. I am a contradiction in a dress. I am sassy, I am sappy, when I'm with you, I am happy. This is my story.
At all my jokes, even though they're true, you don't mind that I'm not blessed.
We make a perfect pair, radiant and rude, so we love and much you guess. We are ogres, we are scary, we are donkeys, we are hairy, we have bold and brand new stories.
Them, you will tell them,
you will hear them, you will smell them. This is our story.
That's how Yolk went on to live on a swamp with a beautiful princess.
And his best friend!
And his best friend.
And a gingerbread man! And a very handsome puppet!
Okay.
And a white rabbit! And a little duckling! And a witch!
Weirdo.
I'm a fairy.
We're a giant box of chocolate here.
not for me. Who was out to get me? That's the way it seems. Disappointment haunted all my dreams. And I saw her face. Now I'm a believer. Not a trace.